Hello friends, welcome to Happy Living. Friends, all of us have goals and dreams. We also want to achieve them and be successful, but very few of us obtain it in spite of being very healthy and without any disability. Now, imagine the life of a disabled person. It's too hard and difficult for them even to do their daily tasks, and going through their dreams is almost impossible. But there are few people who made their disability look very small when compared to their goals. And this transforms them to be the achievers of their dream. In this video, we will have a look at such most successful people with disabilities. But before, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you may not miss our video updates. Guys, breaking the barrier of disability and being independent is itself a great achievement. Going beyond that and fulfilling their dreams is truly amazing. We cannot measure and sort their achievements, but for the number count, I have listed top 11 in this video.
Number 1.
Stephen William Hawking was well known as English theoretical physicist, cosmologist, author, and also worked as director of research at the Center of Theoretical Cosmology at the University of Cambridge. Hawking, at the age of 21, was diagnosed with motor neuron disease, also known as amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, in short ALS, that gradually paralyzed him over the time. But this did not stop him from obtaining PhD degree in applied mathematics and theoretical physics. After the loss of his speech, he was able to communicate only through a speech generating device by using a single cheek muscle. His disability, however, has never been an excuse to give up on his desire to study the universe, specifically the framework of general relativity and quantum mechanics. His book, A Brief History of Time, stayed on the Sunday Times bestsellers list for an outstanding 237 weeks. He died on 14th March 2018 at the age of 76 after living with motor neuron disease for more than 50 years.
Number 2.
Franklin D. Roosevelt, often referred to by his initials FDR, was an American politician who served as the 32nd President of the United States from 1933 until his death in 1945. A member of the Democratic Party who won a record 4 presidential elections. But before his political journey in 1921, Roosevelt contracted a paralytic illness believed to be polio and his legs became permanently paralyzed. In spite of being unable to walk, Roosevelt served as the governor from 1929 to 1933, and in the 1932 presidential elections, he became the President of the United States and helped guide the nation successfully through World War II. FDR proved paralysis wasn't a roadblock to being a great leader.
Number 3.
John Forbes Nash Jr. was an American mathematician who made fundamental contributions to game theory, differential geometry, and the study of partial differential equations. Few years after being out of college, Nash started developing signs of schizophrenia. At the age of 31, in the year 1959, Nash began showing clear signs of mental illness and spent several years at psychiatric hospitals being treated for paranoid schizophrenia. However, the illness never affected his love for mathematics. From 1970, his condition slowly improved, allowing him to return to academic work almost after 25 years by the mid-1980s. His work on geometry and partial differential equations is still considered as outstanding. His theories are widely used in economics. Serving as senior research mathematician at Princeton University during the latter part of his life, he shared the 1994 Nobel Memorial Prize in Economic Sciences with game theorist Reinhard Selten and John Harsney. In 2015, he also shared the Abel Prize with Louis Nirenberg for his work on nonlinear partial differential equations. John Nash is the only person to be awarded both the Nobel Memorial Prize in Economic Sciences and the Abel Prize. His struggles with his illness and his recovery became the basis for Sylvia Nasar's biography, A Beautiful Mind, as well as a film on the same name starring Russell Crowe as Nash.
Number 4.
Nicholas James Ujicic is an Australian-American Christian evangelist, an author, and a motivational speaker born with tetra-amelia syndrome, a rare disorder called phocomelia, characterized by the absence of arms and legs. Originally, the toes of one of his feet were fused. An operation was performed to separate the toes so that he could use them as fingers to grab and do other things. Ever since he was a child, he was the object of bullying at school and was demotivated. He, however, graduated from Griffith University at the age of 21 with a Bachelor of Commerce degree with a double major in accountancy and financial planning. Today, he is a world-renowned motivational speaker who aims at instilling hope in people. In 1990, he won the Australian Young Citizen Award, and in 2005, Nicholas James founded Life Without Limbs, an international non-profit organization. In 2007, he founded Attitude is Altitude, a secular motivational speaking company, and he continues to inspire people throughout the globe. He is definitely one of the most successful people with disabilities of our times.
Number 5.
Steve Land Hardway Morris, professionally known as Steve Wonder, is an American singer, songwriter, musician, and record producer. Steve became blind shortly after his birth and was a child prodigy known as Little Steve Wonder, leading him to sing with Motown's Tamla label at the age of 11. In the year 1963, when Wonder was just 13, his single Fingertips was a number one hit on the Billboard Hot 100, making him the youngest artist ever to top the chart. He is also the only artist who have won the Grammy Award with 3 consecutive album releases. Wonder has sold over 100 million records worldwide, making him one of the best-selling music artists of all time. He has won 25 Grammy Awards, making him the Grammy's most awarded solo artist of all time. He is also noted for his work as an activist for political causes. In 2009, he was named as United Nations Messenger of Peace, and in 2014, he was honored with the Presidential Medal of Freedom.
Number 6.
Helen Keller was an American author and political activist. Although born as a normal child, at the age of 1.5 years, she developed an acute disease which left her deaf and blind. She was assigned a teacher, Anne Sullivan, by the director of Perkins Institute for the Blind. Anne Sullivan became a mentor and life companion to Helen and taught her to communicate. Helen Keller was the first deaf and blind person to earn a college degree. She later on became an activist for the blind and traveled to raise funds for them. She founded the Helen Keller International Organization, aiding research in vision, health, and nutrition. She also helped with the foundation of American Civil Liberties Union and helped raise funds for the American Foundation of the Blind. Helen published a total of 12 books, including her spiritual autobiography, My Religion, and was also a member of Socialist Party in America, and campaigned heavily for women's rights and other labor rights.
Number 7.
Christy Brown was an Irish writer and painter known for overcoming his debilitating cerebral palsy. After his birth, doctors discovered that he had severe cerebral palsy, a neurological disorder which left him almost entirely spastic in his limbs. Until the age of 5, he wasn't able to respond on his own will. Only after that, his left foot was responsive as opposed to the whole body. Over the years, with the support of social worker Catriona Delahunt, Christy had learned to both write and draw himself, with the only limb his left leg. His most recognized works are his autobiography titled My Left Foot in the year 1954 and the book titled down all the days in the year 1970. In the year 1989, based on his autobiography, My Left Foot, an Academy Award-winning film of the same name was made, starring Daniel Day-Lewis as Brown.
Number 8.
Ralph William Brown was the founder and CEO of Brown Corporation. When he was 6 years old, doctors diagnosed him with muscular dystrophy. In the next few years, Ralph lost his ability to walk. He started using a wheelchair at the age of 14. At the age of 15, he created a motorized wagon with his father to help him get around. 5 years later, Brown created a motorized scooter which he called the Tri-Wheeler, using various parts from his cousin's farm. And from there, he designed the world's first wheelchair lift installed in an old postal jeep. As said, necessity is the mother of invention, and Ralph's physical limitations only served to fuel his determination to live independently and prove to the society that people with physical disabilities can participate fully and actively in life. What started as a personal drive to keep independent evolved into Brown Ability, the leading manufacturer of mobility products across the globe. In May 2012, Brown was named as Champion of Change by President Barack Obama.
Number 9.
Marilee Beth Matlin is an American actress, author, and activist. She has been deaf since she was 18 months old due to illness and high fever, but this did not stop her from becoming an actress. She won the Academy Award for Best Actress for her leading role in the film Children of a Lesser God in 1986, and to date, she is the only deaf performer to have won an Academy Award. Having won the award at the age of 21, she is also the youngest winner in this category. Her work in the film and television has resulted in a Golden Globe Award and 4 Emmy nominations. She is also a prominent member of the National Association of the Deaf.
Number 10.
Marla Lee Runyon is an American track and field athlete, road runner, and marathon runner who is legally blind. At age 9, Runyon developed Stargardt's disease, a form of macular degeneration that left her legally blind. She did, however, retain her peripheral vision and could make out shapes and shadows. In 1994, she received her master's degree in education of deaf-blind children. Runyon won 4 gold medals at 1992 Summer Paralympics in long jump and the 100, 200 and 400 meter races. She was placed 8th in the 1500 meter race in 2000 Sydney Olympics, making Runyon the first legally blind athlete to compete in Olympics and the highest finish by an American woman in that event. By 2001, she won her first 3 consecutive 5000 meter national championships, and in 2002 she added the road 5k and 10k national championships. Marla Runyon also released her autobiography No Finish Line, My Life as I See It.
Number 11.
Sudha Chandran is an accomplished Indian actor and dancer. She is a renowned Bharatanatyam dancer who started performing from the tender age of 3. But at the age of 16, she met with a road accident on her way to Tirchi in Tamil Nadu, and this led to gangrene on her foot, and her parents opted to have it amputated. Her dreams of dancing seemed to have shattered, but she didn't lose hope and got an artificial Jaipur leg, which is a form of prosthetic leg. Though it took her 3 years to walk normally, she never lost hope and was ready to perform once again. Later, she was offered to play the lead role in a movie named Mayuri, based on her own life, for which she won several awards. She also became a well-known face in the Indian television and film industry. Her life is an inspiration, and she is one of the very successful people with disabilities who made a big mark from herself. Friends, if you want to know more about their life, please comment below and don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Take care and see you in the next video.